Carl, after KP got the pick six at Utah State, did you feel like you needed a good return tonight on that interception?
Man, I was trying to house it, but I can't never take it to the house. But, yeah, I felt like I needed to score, you know, to start the game off right, put the offense in best position to score.
You told me a couple of weeks ago after the one at Utah State that you have those receiver moves from high school. Looked like your blockers kind of went the other way, and you decided, I'm going to try and juke all these guys.
I still got the receiver skills, you know. I'm just waiting for Coach Bo to put me out there on offense, you know, at receiver. You know, I can make something happen on both sides of the ball. So, you know, I was just out there playing hard, you know, doing my job too.
Carl, I know you didn't play against New Mexico last year, but, you know, they kind of had their way with this against this defense last year. So what changed? And again, I know you didn't play, so maybe this isn't fair to ask, but what was the biggest difference for this defense tonight is maybe what happened last year there?
I think the big difference was last year at practice, you know, our scouts were scoring like every other play. This year, you know, we were stopping our scouts and we were working hard at practice, focusing on takeaways and stuff. So the defense, we just stepped it up. We're a year older and we just did our job today.
On your pick, was it a fairly similar play to the one at Utah State in terms of what happened there?
Nah, it was a little different because at Utah State, you know, I was dropping back. And this game, I seen a running back come at me and I was waiting for him to cut. But he stayed up, so I knew a screen was coming. It just felt weird, and then I caught the ball.
I guess how important was it to, you know, force them into the passing game a little bit tonight? I know they're an option team, but, you know, you guys had five picks.
Yeah, we did good on the first three downs, you know, throughout the game. They probably had a couple first downs the whole game, but we know if we got them in third and long, we was going to make something happen, and that's what we did. We got them in third and long, and we got off the field by pass rushing.
Now, last week you didn't have any turnovers, you didn't force any interceptions, so you feel like this week you just paid attention to a little bit more detail and maybe some of that revenge from last week that you didn't have any.
Yeah, last week we know we messed up because we didn't get no turnovers, so we didn't put the offense in position to score. So this week at practice, we focus on making turnovers against the scouts, and that's what we did tonight. We probably had more turnovers tonight than we had at practice, so that was a big step.
How do you think Josiah did sliding inside and playing some tackle tonight?
You said what?
Josiah moving into tackle.
Yeah, Josiah, he's a beast, you know. At 3-tech, it's hard up in there. They be grinding, you know, and at the weight he is, he did good tonight. He had a few tackles, I believe, and in the pass rush, he's just as good as DN.
Did you get a sense even in practice that he was looking forward to that opportunity? I mean, I know he's a defensive end and he's proven to be a good one. Did you get a sense he kind of relished this opportunity to be a defensive tackle?
Yeah, I knew he knew. He was waiting for it to come. So either way it goes, he's going to do what the coach asked him to do. And he's going to play hard and give it his all. And he just did his job tonight at D-tackle. So we can't wait till he get back. So we waiting for him.